love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all of my dreams. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love. Ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried. I got. What's the use in trying? All you get is pain. When I needed sunshine, I got rain. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love. I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else but not for me. Oh, love was out to get me. That's the way it seemed. Do-do-do-do. Disappointment haunted all of my dreams. And then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer, not a trace of doubt in my mind. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer, I couldn't leave her if I tried. I'm a believer. Welcome back to the 1960s, my veteran friends. A Monkees tune called I'm a Believer. And welcome back to our capo hack, our famous or infamous capo hack, depending upon how you look at it. For those of you that aren't familiar, we're using a clamp-on capo to clamp on strings 1 through 5 from the treble side of the guitar, leaving string 6 open. What that does is it facilitates a nice, big, lush, open-sounding D chord when we're using a D shape. And we use a lot of that in I'm a Believer by the Monkees. Okay, so let's talk about the chords. We've got a D, of course. There's also a D7 in the chorus. There's a G in the chorus. Again, very familiar beginner chords, open position chords. So we've got a D, D seventh, G. We've also got a C. And a C is a 5-string chord. We don't hit string 6, so I typically mute that with my thumb. And then we've got an A. We don't play the 6th string with the A shape either. Every once in a while, I will accidentally hit that 6th string too hard. Let's see, what else do we have to talk about? We've got the strum pattern. Just a simple down, up, 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 down, up. But the one nuance that I add is, so on my first down, I'm hitting the bass note. Sometimes I'm hitting 2 bass notes. Bass note, down, up, down, up, down, up, and the A. Bass note, down, up, down, up, down, up, D. Down, up, down, up, down, up. Bass note, down, up, down, up. Bass note, down, up, 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 down, up. Bass note, down, up, down, up, down, up. Bass note, down, up, down, up, down, up. Bass note, down, up, down, up, down, up. So there, you get it. I'm gonna run out of lung capacity here. Okay, so that's the strum pattern. We've done the chords. There's a hard stop, at the end of the verses. The Monkees are kind of famous for those hard stops. So the way I'm doing that is just hitting the chord and then using my fleshy part of my right palm, my strumming hand palm, to stop all the strings to a dead silence. We used it last week as well, and people are strange. Okay, now for the tricky part. And this is a kind of an intermediate to upper intermediate skill level couple of riffs here. Well, the hammer riff is definitely a little trickier. So the first riff we use in the intro to emulate the organ that the Monkees used in their song is a... So it's pretty simple. It's just a couple of double stops, meaning you're playing two notes at the same time. So the first pair is my ring finger on string 3, fret 2, and my index finger on string 2, fret 1, and that's relative to the capo. So it's two strums together. And then the next one is just strings 3 and 2 open. Okay. And when I start the song, I hit that open fourth string. So it's an open fourth string, and then a... Okay, that's the easy part. Now, the next riff, we're barring, and let's forget we have a capo right now. We're using, instead of using relative to capo terms, we're talking relative to the nut of the guitar term. So on the absolute fifth fret of the guitar, you're going to bar string 6 and 5 with your index finger. And the riff is you pluck, use your pick to hit the sixth string, and you're fretted on the fifth fret. And you're going to hammer with your ring finger and then pluck the fifth string. So the first two are, and the third one is a little faster. Okay, anyway, a little tricky, but with practice you can get it. And if you don't want to play that riff, the song sounds just fine without it. You can start the song, and this is probably how I'll do it with my students in our jam this week. We're just going to start with the D chord. You don't have to. But for those of you that like that sort of thing, it is pretty fun. Okay, so let's do an alternate version of verse 1, just starting it out in the D chord.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else, not for me. Love was out to get me, do-do-do-do, that's the way it seemed. Do-do-do-do, disappointment haunted all of my dreams. And then I saw her face. Not a trace, a doubt in my mind. I'm in love, ooh, I'm a believer. I couldn't leave her if I tried.
So rather than do the riff, you can just go to an A chord.
I'm in love.
Couple of different ways to play I'm a Believer. For the adventures, or for more of a beginning level, just playing that A chord right there. So there you have it. I'm a Believer by the Monkees using our capo hack. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Have a wonderful week, and I look forward to sending you another song next week. Until then, adios, my friends.